Okay, everybody, now we get to the good stuff. Now, a Sprite, other than a fabulous soda beverage, is the character that you see down here to the left. Our current Sprite is a cat, and it can be literally named anything that you want it to be named. Do you see this little eye button right here? If you click on that, you'll get some great information about your Sprite. For example, let's say that instead of Scratch Cat, I want to name my cat Orange. Boom, there you go. So now I have the name, and it's set for whatever it is that I want. Now, there are a couple of other cool buttons down here for what you can actually do to manipulate your Sprite. For example, let's say that I want him to be rotated a little bit. See right here where it says direction 90 degrees? If you grab this little tab on top of the circle and you start to spin it around, what is going on? My Scratch Cat is going all over the place. Poor little Orange. Boom. And then bring it sort of back to where it was before, right at 90 degrees. Play with some of these other icons down here and see what else you can do to actually manipulate your Sprite. Okay, let's go back. Right now, our Sprite is a cat, but what's really cool about Scratch is that you can literally customize your Sprite to be anything you'd like. Okay, now I have to say, I love to go dancing, and I'm interested in creating sort of a disco scene. Well, what sort of character would I have in a disco? Probably someone who's dancing. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna find a Sprite that represents more what I'm looking for. Up here where it says New Sprite, there's a tiny little Sprite icon right next to it. If you click on that, all of a sudden you're taken to our Sprite library, which gives you literally hundreds of different options for what you can actually select for your Sprite character. Oh, and look at that. I see a bunch of people dancing. Let's keep scrolling down, see what I can find. So I'm having a little bit of trouble finding what I need. So let's go to one that's themed, music and dance. Look at this. Jay looks perfect. I'm gonna choose him. There you go. Now I have a second Sprite that's been added on top of my Sprite cat, but I don't really want my cat right now. So does anybody remember? How do we get rid of it? Nice job. Up at the cursor tools, click the scissor icon and bring it down. Boom. Now all we have left is Jay. Now, there are actually some other options that you can choose if for some reason the Sprite library doesn't have exactly what you're looking for. So let's take a look at these other three items right here. This little paintbrush tool allows you to actually go in and create your own. You'll notice that we moved also from the scripts tab to the costumes tab. So if you go ahead and start drawing, you can actually make your own character. So let's see, I'm just gonna go ahead and make a happy face. And let's say he's got a little bit of like a hair squiggle. Boom, there you go. And here's my Sprite conveniently located right here on the stage. Now again, another Sprite was created and I don't think this is really gonna fit in with my disco scene. So let's just go ahead and get rid of it. Now don't get me wrong, picking a Sprite from the library or drawing one yourself is pretty cool, but I have to admit these next two icons are even more of my favorites than the ones before that. This little file folder right here, it actually allows you to upload a picture from your computer itself. So let's say that you have, for example, an embarrassing picture of a friend of yours. Guess what? You can make that into a Sprite. It's fantastic. What else is even more amazing is that this tiny little camera icon right here allows you to actually take a picture and upload that as a Sprite. Now, it's up to your jurisdiction how you choose to use this, but it is pretty cool to go ahead and see yourself as an actual Sprite in Scratch.